What's going on, everybody? This is Afro Think Tank. Listen, Black YouTube and Black subscribers. Phil Scott is a fucking idiot. Don't listen to anything that fucking idiot has to say. He don't know shit about politics, and he's lying to you, and he's feeding you misinformation. Tariq Nasheed, he's a fucking idiot. All he is a C-lister celebrity who never truly made it, but YouTube has given him an avenue to make money off idiots. All right, so don't listen to Tariq Nasheed. The bear, Ruckus Bear, he's the biggest idiot. And just don't listen to anything he got to say. You know who Mr. Ruckus Boochie Bear is, all right? All of these Black YouTubers, all of them, not all of them, the ones that are famous because they like to mix white supremacy and hip-hop Black culture wrapping paper, stop listening to these fools. They don't know what they're talking about. They're simply entertaining you with cheap entertainment and are feeding you the propaganda that they receive from Massa. You understand? So here, the Pan-African here, the intelligent guy is going to give you real information. Information you can't refute. Information that's readily available to anybody who honestly want to know the truth. Democrats are better than Republicans, okay? Now, for all these Black coonarians on the internet who swear up and down that they're Americans all of a sudden, Black Americans, they forget America is a nationality and that we have America's best interest at heart, and that as an American, you can talk about this economy of America, you know, with the rest of the Americans. All right. So as an American myself, I'm going to tell you what's really happening in America for those who actually care about America being the country that you reside in and that you refuse to leave. Because, look, if it was so bad, you should bring your ass to Africa like me. All right, I'm in Africa right now. I got this. This is mine. Right. So if you don't actually plan on going to Africa, right, and getting your birthright, and you want to stay in America, the place of your recent ancestors' birth and struggle, well, you should understand what's really happening in America as an American, all right? So without further ado, let me give you some information so that these dumb, stupid, freaking content creators, they don't even create content. They regurgitate white supremacy content, thinking it's content, because the Russians are giving them the rubles for it, all right? But anyway, without further ado, listen to this real information about America and its economy and who, in fact, delivers you a better economy. And who puts more money in your pocket? And understand, you have the American economy, then you have the global economy, which is affected by global issues and cannot be helped by just national issues within America. You understand? You got local politics, you got national politics, then you got global politics and global situations that cause us, America, to be put in certain situations with the globe. Some things are bigger than Republicans and Democrats. But anyway, without further ado, this is Afro Think Tank. Learn some teaching. I'm out.
Donald Trump is a 78-year-old billionaire who has not stopped whining about his problems since he rode down his golden escalator 9 years ago. The ranting and the raving about crazy conspiracy theory. You got the two-hour speeches, word salad, constant attempts to sell you stuff. Who does that? Selling you gold sneakers and a $100,000 watch and most recently a Trump Bible. If you saw it on Saturday Night Live, you'd say, well, no, that's going too far. No, he's doing that. I don't have to tell a lot of you, raising kids is hard. I remember changing diapers. You think Donald Trump ever changed a diaper? Tim is a veteran, he is a teacher, he's a coach, he's a hunter. He can also take a vintage truck apart and put it back together. Do you think Donald Trump has ever changed a tire in his life? I'm just trying to picture. And the reason some people think, well, I don't know, I remember that economy when he first came in being pretty good. Yeah, it was pretty good, because it was my economy. That was, he didn't do nothing except those big tax cuts. The other day, his running mate had the nerve to say, Donald Trump salvaged the Affordable Care Act. Donald Trump spent his entire presidency trying to tear it down. And by the way, he couldn't even do that right.
which is the largest driving factor of inflation and my wallet not going as far.
But by many accounts, the economy is doing very well here in America.
Unemployment is low. The economy is still growing at a robust rate. Inflation is down, but you're right. Prices are higher than they were before.
Lots of people clearly aren't feeling it.
I mean, yeah, and gas prices are above what they were the last year of Donald Trump's administration, but also last year of Donald Trump's administration, no one was driving. We were in the middle of COVID. And so when you compare 4 years ago to now, a lot of those numbers are depressed because of what COVID did. And, you know, we talk about inflation, and yes, it hurts. It hurts everyone. It's something unlike unemployment that every single American, no matter how wealthy or poor you feel, you go to the grocery store and buy something, you see the prices are up. You don't necessarily lose your job in a recession, but you could see inflation. But it's also a worldwide problem, and it's something that affected our audience in the UK, I'm sure, Germany, Japan, all of the Western countries. They all dealt with a spike in inflation, and the US, comparatively speaking, actually inflation wasn't as bad here. And so when you hear conservatives try to lay this all at the feet of Joe Biden and some of the spending plans that he had shortly after he took the White House, there is also the fact that this was a post-COVID global phenomenon.
Right, listen, inflation has made America unaffordable, period. You know, so it doesn't matter if the unemployment rate's at 3.7 or 4.2. If at the end of the week you're trying to pay in your bills and your dollar doesn't stretch as far as it did the previous administration, that's going to be a problem. And that's what has that is what has troubled the entire Biden-Harris administration. You know, they for nearly 40 months. They have failed to hit their own target of inflation, which made America unaffordable.
The American economy, some people in the audience don't like facts, has grown twice as fast as Canada's, triple the EU's, eight times as much as the UK's, right? That is the American economy right now. It's had really bad inflation.
And it's unaffordable
for Anthony's put it in context, but real wages are up, household net worth is up, unemployment's at a record low. The economy, by any objective measure, is doing well now.
Well, golly gee. Looks like the Democrats deliver the best economic results time and again. And who was the worst in terms of job growth? Donald Trump and today's Republican Party. Or let's consider GDP. Well, gosh darn it, looks like the Republicans are full of, as Joe would say, malarkey. But here's the truth. Donald Trump and today's Republican Party were again the absolute worst. Anyway, the bottom line is tax cuts for the rich and trickle-down economics are and always have been voodoo economics. That malarkey sells politically but stinks practically. If you're concerned about the economy, there is only one logical choice. You know what it is. The facts speak for themselves. Now, go vote.
Does the economy do better under Republicans or under Democrats? What if you were to take a look at all of the economies for the last 70 years? Every economy from Truman during the post-World War II period all the way through Obama. Now, there's a study that came out called, let's take a look at this paper here. I'll see if I can flip my camera around. There we go. It's a two-page paper, very short paper. Look at that. It's already at the end here. The paper is called The Economy Under Democrat versus Republican Presidents, and it's by the Joint Economic Committee. They are a nonpartisan group of 10 Republicans and 10 Democrats. Now, if we look here, it says the economy has grown faster under Democratic presidents. And that kind of surprised me. It surprised me for a few reasons. First of all, I have a lot of my friends who are fiscal conservatives and libertarians who are staunch conservatives and believe in lean government. So according to this paper, the economy has been about 1.6 times as good under Democrats as under Republicans. But there's so much more to say on this paper. What I want to do is I want to actually tag every economist I know on TikTok because although this paper is very interesting, I'm interested in why. And this paper does not really go into a whole lot of why. It says that it's a combination of good policy and good luck. It takes into account just the fact that luck is part of it. You know, I think a lot of with the economy, sometimes it's kind of like the weather. And if you have smooth sailing or if you have stormy waters, it's how you adjust your sails in some cases. Now, I hope you guys follow my TikTok. I will be going on a podcast here in 2 weeks. I'm going to join a fiscal conservative who is a libertarian, a staunch libertarian, that believes in the leanest government possible. I'll also have a friend of mine who identifies as centrist, and he doesn't really explain what he means to me by centrist, but he's a small business owner, and he tends to lean a bit more left. Should be a very interesting conversation, but I want to tag a whole bunch of economists here and see if we can address, without being partisan, what policies specifically would be considered good policy from the federal and state and even local governments, and what would be considered good luck that might inform why the Democrats do so much better on this study. I'm very curious, and I'm trying very hard not to be partisan. I don't bring the study up to be like, ha ha, Democrats are right, Republicans are wrong. No. I want to elevate the discussion, so we're talking about ideas here. So I'm hoping that I can, you know, tag some economists and we can talk about specific issues and specific policy that might be considered good or bad from an economics perspective, or from the perspectives within economics. So thanks for watching.